প্রতিদিন সকাল 9টায় ক্লাস 10 থেকে 12-এর ছাত্রছাত্রীদের এই অনলাইন ক্লাস চলবে আনন্দবার্তা নিউজ চ্যানেল, আনন্দবার্তা ফেসবুক এবং আনন্দবার্তার ইউটিউব চ্যানেলে। তাই বাডওয়ান মডেল স্কুলের সকল ছাত্রছাত্রীকে 14 এপ্রিল সকাল 9টা থেকে এই অনলাইন ই লার্নিং ক্লাস অ্যাটেন্ড করার জন্য আবেদন জানানো হচ্ছে।
You, as we all know that due to this current situation, COVID-19, we are all staying at home. But staying at home, we can learn and we can study something new, okay? Please concentrate on your class. As this is my first day in this online classes, on your e-learning classes, I welcome you all. And let's start from the first chapter, okay? You know that in unit 1 is related to the reproduction. There is the 4 topics, that is reproduction in organism, then separately reproduction in the sexual flowering plant, and another one the reproduction in the human beings, and another one reproductive health. So I will start from the first topic, that is reproduction in organism. Okay, reproduction. All of you know that, and you are familiar with the term. What is reproduction? That is the produce of the new ones or younger ones of any individuals of their similar kinds. Before entering the reproduction, we will go through, there is the some time between the birth and death. So there is the some time between the birth and death, that is called lifespan. We can divide lifespan into the 5 parts, okay? The another stages of life one, first one birth, obviously give birth than young ones. Second one, juvenile phases or vegetative phases. Juvenile phases or vegetative phase, that is pre-reproductive phase. Here, in the case of the animal, you can say that juvenile phase. In the case of the plants, you can say vegetative phases. Juvenile phases and vegetative phase is the pre-reproductive phase. There is the animals becoming the capable of the doing reproduction. Next one, maturity or reproductive phase. Next, then after entering into the reproductive stage, it is the post-reproductive stage, that is aging, deterioration of the body. Next one, death, that is the end of the lifespan, okay? So this is the stage of the lifespan of the human. It may be take 2 months time, it may be take shortest of the time. Lifespan may be from the few minutes to thousands of year, okay? And today we will discuss only this stage of the lifespan, that is reproductive stage. The total topics and total subject that is today we will read, that is the related to the reproduction in the organism. So let's start from the first. Permanent marker. Hey, what do I do? So, juvenile phase, reproductive phase, and so the reproduction. What is reproduction? Reproduction is the giving birth of the young ones of their similar kind, okay? That is called reproduction. There is so many factors are related to the reproduction, responsible for the reproduction, physiological structure, the mental development, the other environmental factor, that their light, that is water, all are, if there is no suitable condition is present there, the organisms are unable to reproduce. So many factors, external factors and internal factors is responsible for the reproduction. Next one, what is the purposes, importance of the reproduction? Importance of the reproduction, that is, you all of you know that first one, that is the maintenance of the population. Second one, maintenance of the offsprings or number of offsprings of the individual. So first one, the increase the number of the organisms of a population. Second one, you can say that the production of the similar kind of the species. Third one, obviously create variations and the new species for the adaptation. Fourth one, obviously it maintains the existence of the organisms. If there is no reproductions will occur, there will be the, it is very difficult to, it would be the life will be vanished from the earth. That is the importance of the reproduction. Next one, that is, you can say that the modes of the reproduction. There is two modes of reproduction, asexual and sexual reproduction. So many different type of the reproductions are there. So you can, so asexual and sexual reproduction. Today we will totally discuss, there is different parts of the asexual reproduction and sexual reproduction, and we will totally discuss about the asexual reproduction, okay. So asexual reproduction, what is asexual reproduction and sexual reproduction? Asexual reproduction and sexual reproduction, there is so many totally different from each other. First one, asexual reproduction, you can find the simple species, the unicellular, and sexual reproduction you can say in the both unicellular and multicellular, especially in the higher animals, okay. Higher group of animals, you can say that they are reproduced through the sexual reproduction. Simple and asexual reproduction, that is, and the sexual reproduction you can find out in the higher plants. Next one, asexual reproduction going through this only, or there is involvement of only one parent, that is uniparental. Next one, that is, in the sexual reproduction two parents are involved, okay, that is, you can say that it is biparental. Next difference, gamete formation and fusion does not occur, okay. Gamete formation and fusion does not occur. There, gamete formation and fusion must occur. Must be occurred here, okay. Next one, there is fertilization does not occur. But fertilization occur. Another, there is only occurs the mitosis division. And meiosis and mitosis both occur.
Dad.
দেখা যাচ্ছে না তো মাইটোসিস অ্যান্ড মিওসিস বোথ অকার অনন্ত ওয়ান দ্য রিপ্রোডাক্টিভ ইউনিট ইন অ্যাসেক্সুয়াল রিপ্রোডাকশন প্রোডিউস ফ্রম সোমাটিক সেলস সো ইট ইজ কল্ড সোমাটোজেনিক রিপ্রোডাকশন বাট ইন দিস কেস দ্য সেক্সুয়াল রিপ্রোডাকশন দ্য গ্যামিটস আর দ্য রিপ্রোডাকটিভ ইউনিট আর ফর্ম ফ্রম জার্ম সেলস নো গ্যামিট ফর্মেশন অকার্স দ্য সেক্সুয়াল রিপ্রোডাকশন সো দ্যাট ইজ কল অ্যাগামোজেনেসিস গ্যামেট ফর্মেশন হিয়ার গ্যামেট ফর্মেশন অবভিয়াসলি অকার ওকে সো দ্য বেসিক ডিফারেন্স বিটুইন দ্য সেক্সুয়াল রিপ্রোডাকশন অ্যান্ড সেক্সুয়াল রিপ্রোডাকশন ফার্স্ট ওয়ান দ্য সেক্সুয়াল রিপ্রোডাকশন ইউ ক্যান ফাইন্ড আউট ইন দ্য সিম্পল অর্গানিজম সেক্সুয়াল রিপ্রোডাকশন ইউ ক্যান ফাইন্ড আউট ইনসাইড দ্য হায়ার প্ল্যান্টস নেক্সট ওয়ান অ্যাসেক্সুয়াল রিপ্রোডাকশন ইনভলভ অনলি ওয়ান টাইপ অফ পেরেন্ট সো ফর দ্য রিজন দ্যাট ইজ কল্ড ইউনিপ্যারেন্টাল নেক্সট ওয়ান দেয়ার ইজ দ্য সেক্সুয়াল রিপ্রোডাকশন বোথ পেরেন্টস আর ইনভলভ সো দ্যাট ইজ কল বাইপ্যারেন্টাল নেক্সট ওয়ান দ্য ফর্মেশন অফ দ্য গ্যামেট অ্যান্ড ফিউশন অফ দ্য গ্যামেট ডাজ নট অকার ইয়ার বাট ইন দ্য কেস অফ দ্য সেক্সুয়াল রিপ্রোডাকশন বোথ অকার ইয়ার ফার্টিলাইজেশন সো দেয়ার ইজ নো গ্যামেট ফর্মেশন অকার সো দ্যাটস ওয়াই দেয়ার ইজ নো ফার্টিলাইজেশন ডাজ নট অকার বাট ফার্টিলাইজেশন ইজ দ্য মোস্ট ইম্পর্টেন্ট পার্ট অফ দ্য সেক্সুয়াল রিপ্রোডাকশন ইউ নো দ্যাট অ্যান্ড অনলি হিয়ার ইজ দ্য মিওসিস ডিভিশন ইজ মাইটোসিস ডিভিশন ইজ অকার্স ইউ নো দ্যাট বিকজ দ্য ক্রোমোজোম নাম্বার ইজ সিমিলার টু দেয়ার প্যারেন্ট সেল বাট ইন দ্য কেস অফ দ্য সেক্সুয়াল রিপ্রোডাকশন ফার্স্ট ওয়ান দ্যাট ইজ অকার্স দ্য মিওসিস ডিভিশন অ্যান্ড আফটার দ্যাট ইট ফর্মস দ্য মাইটোসিস ডিভিশন অ্যানাদার ওয়ান রিপ্রোডাকশিভ ইউনিট দ্যাট ইজ দ্য স্পোর দ্যাট ইজ প্রোডিউস ফ্রম দ্য এনি বডি পার্টস দ্যাট ইজ ফর্ম ফ্রম দ্য সোমাটিক সেল সো দ্যাট ইজ কল সোমাটোজেনিক রিপ্রোডাকশন সেক্সুয়াল রিপ্রোডাক্টিভ ইউনিটস ইউ নো দ্যাট দে আর ফর্ম ফ্রম দ্য জার্ম সেলস বিকজ দে আর ক্রোমোজোম নাম্বার ইজ দ্য হ্যাপ্লয়েড অ্যান্ড দে আর ইজ নো গ্যামেট ফর্মেশন অকার সো দ্যাট ইজ কল অ্যাগামোজেনেসিস অ্যান্ড দে আর ইজ গ্যামেট ফর্মেশন অবভিয়াসলি অকার দিস ইজ দ্য বেসিক ডিফারেন্স বিটুইন দ্য অ্যাসেক্সুয়াল রিপ্রোডাকশন অ্যান্ড সেক্সুয়াল রিপ্রোডাকশন নেক্সট উই মুভ টু দ্য ডিফারেন্ট টাইপস অফ অ্যাসেক্সুয়াল রিপ্রোডাকশনস ফার্স্ট ইউ ইফ ইউ গো থ্রু দিস টপিক্স অর ইফ ইউ গো থ্রু দিস সাবজেক্ট ইউ হ্যাভ টু কভার সামথিংস দেয়ার ইজ দ্য কনসেপ্ট ম্যাপ দ্যাট ইজ কল্ড মাইন্ড ম্যাপ অর কনসেপ্ট ম্যাপ হোয়ার দ্য টপিক ইউ শুড কভার ইন দিস চ্যাপ্টার দ্যাট ইজ ফার্স্ট ওয়ান অবভিয়াসলি ইন্ট্রোডাকশন দ্যাট ইজ রিপ্রোডাকশন হোয়াট ইজ রিপ্রোডাকশন নেক্সট ওয়ান দ্যাট ইজ লাইফ স্প্যান ডিফারেন্ট স্টেজেস অফ দ্য লাইফ স্প্যান নেক্সট ওয়ান মোডস অফ রিপ্রোডাকশন সেক্সুয়াল অ্যান্ড অ্যাসেক্সুয়াল নেক্সট ওয়ান অ্যাসেক্সুয়াল রিপ্রোডাকশন ডিফারেন্ট টাইপস অফ অ্যাসেক্সুয়াল রিপ্রোডাকশন দ্যাট ইজ ফিশন বার্ডিং ফ্র্যাগমেন্টেশন রিজেনারেশন স্পোর ফর্মেশন অ্যান্ড নেক্সট দ্য লাস্ট ওয়ান সেক্সুয়াল রিপ্রোডাকশন অ্যান্ড ইটস টাইপস অ্যান্ড ইটস স্টেজেস দ্যাট ইজ পোস্ট ফার্টিলাইজেশন ফার্টিলাইজেশন অ্যান্ড প্রিভিয়াস দ্যাট ইজ প্রি ফার্টিলাইজেশন ফার্টিলাইজেশন অ্যান্ড পোস্ট ফার্টিলাইজেশন দিস ইজ দ্য টোটাল টপিক ইউ শুড কভার ইন দিস pages. Okay, that is the topics, and it is, you can recall that one, and we will start from the asexual reproduction and types of the asexual reproduction. So many types are there in the asexual reproduction. Asexual reproduction is the very fast process. They are grow rapidly, they divide the cell rapidly and they grow very rapidly, but the sexual reproduction is taking the too much time, and there is the, it is a very slow process. And you know that there is the different lifespan of the animals, and so they means there may be some animals they can live for the few minutes, and there is so many animals they can live thousands of years. Okay, if you can say that the shortest lifespan, obviously there is one fly, that is mayfly, or some bacteria, and some bacteria, mayfly, Apia mellifera. Its lifespan is 24 hours, that is called one day. Within one day, as it is an insect, it can completed all the life cycle, that is, you can say that egg, larva, then started molting, then form pupa, then it is attain the adult stage, and after that it will reproduce and then it will die. Okay, it is the lifespan of the Epimeroptera. Longest lifespan, so many animals are there in the longest lifespan, that is, you can say that tortoise, and there is another unio or mollusk present in the marine, that is ocean quahog. Lifespan 405 to 507 years. There is one plant, that is Lomansia tasmanica, one plant name. Lifespan 4300 years. Okay, so long it can live. So many animals are there, they can live for the thousands of years, and so many animals are there, they can live through the or just few minutes or few seconds or few days. Okay, that is the shortest and longest lifespan. And in the case of the asexual reproduction, the animals, before attaining their day, they can divide themselves, especially in the binary fission. They can reproduce from their parent cells, and they can attain the daughter cells, and then after that they maturity, and before attaining the maturity they can divide themselves. So you can say that the animals who are capable of doing asexual reproduction, they are maybe motile, not immortal in nature. Okay, they are not mortal, but in the sexual reproduction, the animals have certain lifespan. After some years or certain ages of the year, they can die. Types of asexual reproduction. First one, you can say that binary fission. You can say that fission. Fission is divide the parent body and produce the daughter cell. Fission three types: binary fission, next one multiple fission, third one plasmotomy. Okay, binary fission, multiple fission, plasmotomy, that is fission. Second one, budding. Budding you can find in the animals and microorganisms, and you can say that in plants and animal. Budding in yeast, and they are different. First you can say that budding in yeast, next one is budding in animals. Budding animals are three types: exogenous, endogenous, and strobilation. So fission three types: binary fission, multiple fission, and plasmotomy. Second one, the budding. Budding, there is another type of budding you can find in the yeast, and another type of budding you can find in the animals. That one exogenous, means bud forms outside the parent body. Endogenous, you know that is inside the parent body. And strobilation, there is the repetitive segments in their body, that is called strobila. And then these segments separated from the parent body and form the larva. And you can see it in the jellyfish, you can say that Aurelia, you can find out the strobilation. Okay, next one, fragmentation. Fragmentation, obviously parent body that is divided into the so many fragments and produce the new individual from this each fragment. Next one, gamete is the one type of spore or gamma cap formation. You can read about the Markensia in your previous class. The Markensia form this gamma cap and it is produced the gamete. Next, spore formation. Spore formation, different types of spore you can find out, that is juice spore, who are motile in nature. Juice spore, which is motile in nature. Another spore, they are non-motile, they are conidia, chlamydospore, oidia, spore angiospore. Okay, and the last one, vegetative propagation. Vegetative propagation is that the plant's body parts that produce the new individual from their different body parts. It is two types, natural and artificial, or horticulture you can say that also. The different parts of the plant body you will take and you can collect them, and you can obviously nourish them with the required components, and then they are able to produce the roots, and from that they you can obtain the new plantlets. Okay, that is the total different modes of the asexual reproduction. First one, by fission, binary fission, when the body is divided into two parts. Second one, multiple fission, when the body is divided into so many parts. And third one, plasmotomy, the multinucleated cells containing animals, so that plasmotomy. Next one, budding. You can say budding is the outer outgrowth of the parent's body. Then it is detached from the parent body after the maturity. You can find the buds in the yeast one type, and another buds you can find in the animals. So that is called the exogenous bud, which is the outgrowth of the parent body. Endogenous bud, which forms inside the parent body. And another one is called the exogenous, endogenous, and strobilation, that is the repetitive segment of their body, you can find in the Aurelia. Next one, fragmentation, you can find in the planaria animals, and also Spirogyra, the blue green algae, that is their body fragmented so many parts, and each parts produce the new individual. Gamma carps, that is produced inside the Markensia, that is the fungi, and they produce the new individual from the gamete formation. Next one, spore formation, juice spore. You can find juice spore in the Chlamydomonas. They are biflagellated and they can move here and there just like animals. Next, conidia. You can say in the conidia, you can find in the penicillium. Next, Chlamydospore, you can find in the Chlamydomonas. Oidia, that is, you can find the rhizopus, agarica, spore angiospore. You also can find out inside the rhizopus and agaricus. Okay, and vegetative and natural propagation, that is the different body parts of the plants that is divided, and they also you can cut down from that artificially, and then you nourish them in the growth hormone, that is auxins, and after that you can produce the new platelets from this vegetative parts of the plants. Okay, so this is the total different mode of the asexual reproduction. Now I will give the details each of them. First, binary fission. Fission, what is fission? Splitting of the body or dividing of the body. And produce new young ones and produce young ones. That is fission. Binary fission means parent body divided into two daughter cells. Amoeba, you can find out that in amoeba there is the parent body first divided, and obviously in the binary fission and multiple fission first the nuclear division occurs and after that cytoplasm occurs. Okay, so first karyokinesis is followed by the cytokinesis. Nucleus division start and then it is divided, and cytokinesis, cytoplasm also start to divide. Then it produces two new daughter amoeba. So that is binary fission. Okay. This one is binary fission inside the amoeba occurs. Next one, multiple fission. Multiple fission, that is the parent body produce many daughter cells. You can find multiple fission amoeba in multiple fission occurs not in the suitable condition. When there is the unfavorable condition is appeared, then the micro simple organisms start to divide it. For the multiple fission, first one is amoeba, second one you can find out the plasmodium, the malarial parasite. So what happened in amoeba? In the unfavorable condition the amoeba start to reduce their pseudopodia and it forms that round like structure. Okay, it forms this round like structure, and after that there is the secretion of the layer enzymes around this amoeban, but there is three layer of the thick layer of the secretion and form a coat surround this amoeban body, that is called cyst. Okay, and nucleus start to divide it into so many numbers, and then this daughter nuclei is surrounded by the cytoplasm and cell membrane and it form the daughter amoeba. Okay, but it is still now it is inside the cyst wall. After that the when the daughter nuclei will mature and when they come in the contact of the favorable condition, this cyst wall start to rupture and all the daughter nuclei start to come out from this wall. Okay, that is the, and as there is the cyst forms around the amoeba, this is called encystation. Multiple fissuring amoebar body in occurring two types, encystation and sporulation. Both are occur in the unfavorable condition, but encystation occur, there is so many nucleus that is surrounded by the cell membrane and cytoplasm from daughter nuclei after start to rupture, and sometimes it is unable to form the cyst, then it form the spore, and the same like that after the formation of the spore, when they come in the contact with their suitable condition, they start to rupture and produce the daughter amoeba. Plasmodium parasite, both they are fine. The Plasmodium also, so two types of the multiple fission. In the, because you know that the Plasmodium completed is two types life stage, one in the female anopheles body, another one the human blood cells. Okay, so cyzygoni and sporogony. Cyzygoni, it is found in the human blood cells. And sporogony, it is found in the female anopheles. Cyzygoni obviously produce the skyzygote and the daughter cells, and their sporogony is called the sporozoite, and the daughter cells which produce from the skyzygoni, that is called merozoite. Same like that amoeba, there is also the only one cells, then the nucleus start to divide and form the so many nucleus, that is called the skyzygote, you can say that. And after the formation of this nucleus, that is surrounded by the cytoplasm and the cell wall, from the daughter nuclei, and after the development, that the wall is ruptured, and the daughter cell, that is called merozoite, come out from this structure. This can show by the Plasmodium. Okay, so amoeba show the encystation and sporulation, and the Plasmodium shows skyzygoni and sporogony. Next one, plasmotomy. It is, you can find in the multinucleated body, that is opalina. Opalina just looking like that one type of animal whose body contains so many nucleus, just like that, so many nucleus are present in their body. Cilia and flagella, unicellular, you know that they contain the cilia and flagella. In the previous two division, you show that the first nucleus started divided, then cytoplasm. But in this case, totally opposite. First cytoplasm start to divide, and after the division into the daughter cell, the nucleus start to divide. If there is the number of the, it is, there is some different, you just concentrate on that, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 and 12. If there is 12 nucleus is present, when it divides, first cytoplasmic division occurs, that is no, there is no need to the equal division of the nucleus will be occurred, okay. There may be is 12, there may be 8. There may be 5 and there may be 7. Then when it is totally divided into and the two daughter cells, and it's attained the maturity and developed into the animals, when it form the adult form of the opalina from the daughter cell, it just then the nucleus will started to divide, and it regain the stuck just like the structure for about their mother cell, just looking like their mother cell. The number of the nucleus will be the same when it attain the maturity, not in the daughter form, okay. Then each of their this nucleus start to divide and they form the 12 number of the nucleus, okay. So, this is the unique features of the plasmotomy. Each of the daughter cell, when they divide, there is no need to, because there is so many number of nucleus is present. In the case of the daughter cell, there is no need to num of the extra number of the nucleus. So, they not start to divide, but when they attain the maturity, they are just same looking like their mother cells or parent cells, and there also will be the number of the nucleus will be the same, okay. That is plasmotomy. Next one, budding. You can say the budding in yeast. You read about the previous classes that yeast, there is the body like this and there is small outgrowth occurs from the parent cell, okay. Now vacuole is present and nucleus is also present. After that, the nucleus start to divide and give the sum of the part, and inside this motherboard to pair daughter cells. Vacuoles also same like that. After that, their nucleus and vacuoles totally divided and small outgrowth is coming out from the mother body. There is the separate nucleus and vacuoles also occur. And here is also the nucleus and vacuoles also occur. When is that in the maturity, it form the daughter cells. They are totally detached from the mother body, okay. So, that is the budding in the is total the outside or outgrowth of the body, and it is from the outside of the mother body, and then it form this totally different from the or detached from the mother body and from the different individuals. That is the budding in the yeast. Next one, that is budding in animals. First one, exogenous. Exogenous bud forms outside the parent body. Okay, buds form outside the parent body. You can see them inside the hydra. There is the small outgrowth occurs from the parent body. And the outgrowth also contain the tentacle just looking like the same as their mother. And when they contains the maturity, attain the maturity, that is the total different hydra will form from the parental body. A small outgrowth that is from the another hydra. This is called exogenous buds is form. Next one, endogenous. Endogenous buds forms in the sponges. You know the sponges body just looking like that, and there is small gametes are formed. The gametes are looking like that. They contain the cell that is called archaeocytes, small cells. It is totally covered by mucilaginous covering, and it contains spicules for the protective mucilaginous covering, because it is, you know, that water present in the water, so the mucus is the present to protect from the rotting from the any type of the watery substances or surroundings, and the opening is called micropyle. It is called archaeocyte. So when it comes in the contacts of any type of substratum, there the micropyle, if there is any substratum, the micropyle attached with this substratum, and in the suitable condition, the archaeocytes come outside of this and it form the new individual. Another one, strobilation. does look like a book-like structure. Their body has repetitive segments present in their body. Tentacles are present. Each part form the one type of Aurelia. Each segment divided and form Aurelia. That is, you can say that jellyfish. Okay. This process is called strobilation. So there is the budding is completed. Next one, you can say the fragmentation. You know that the Spirogyra and another animals, they are just looking like that, and they differentiate their body in the different parts, and each part produce the new individuals. Thank you for the today. The other parts and rest of the part we will upload it in the next video. And stay tuned. Please stay safe and stay inside the home. Thank you very much. Have a great day.
করোনার জেরে লকডাউন, আর এই লকডাউনের জেরে বন্ধ সমস্ত স্কুল কলেজ সহ শিক্ষা প্রতিষ্ঠান। ছাত্রদের কথা ভেবে, ছাত্রদের ভবিষ্যতের কথা ভেবে বাডওয়ান মডেল স্কুল শুরু করতে চলেছে অনলাইনে ই লার্নিং ক্লাস। এই অনলাইন ক্লাস শুরু হচ্ছে 14 এপ্রিল সকাল 9টা থেকে। প্রতিদিন সকাল 9টায়